Imam Abu Hanifa rahimahullah ta'ala rahmatan wasi'a, he was a faqih. And many people, they think that fiqh is something which comes beneath hadith and muhaddithun. Everyone has a great status in Islam. We all need muhaddithun, hadith as well. So what they did cannot be replaced by anything else. What the mufassirun, tafsir writers of Quran have done, that is a separate and very important place in Islam. First of all, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions the word fiqh, tafaqquh fi al-deen in Quran. There are several verses, ayat in Quran. The most famous one is the one in Surah Tawbah, verse 122. وَمَا كَانَ الْمُؤْمِنُونَ لِيَنْفِرُوا كَافَّةً فَلَوْلَا نَفَرَ مِنْ كُلِّ فِرْقَةٍ طَائِفَةٌ لِيَتَفَقَّهُ فِي الدِّينِ وَلِيُنْذِرُوا قَوْمَهُمْ إِذَا رَجَعُوا إِلَيْهِمْ لَعَلَّهُمْ يَحْذَرُونَ. It is not necessary for all the believers to go forth. So why should it not be that a group from every section of them goes forth so that they may acquire perfect understanding of the faith and so that they may warn their people when they return to them so that they may take due care of the rules of Sharia? There is only two interpretations, famous interpretations of this verse. One is that everyone shouldn't go for jihad. Someone should stay behind so that they can learn. And when these mujahideen come back, they can teach them fiqh and they can teach them their religion. That's one interpretation. Second one is that everyone shouldn't go out to seek knowledge. Few should go. And then they can come back when they have learned, and then they can convey and teach those who do not have the knowledge of Islam, of Deen. Now the word لِيَتَفَقَّهُ فِي الدِّينِ تَفَقُّهُ فِقْهُ have been used. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions the word fiqh also, for example, regards to the kuffar. Allah says, فَمَا لِهَاؤُلَاءِ الْقَوْمِ لَا يَكَادُونَ يَفْقَهُونَ حَدِيثًا. Which again, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that what has happened to these non-Muslims, kuffar, that they do not have the understanding of words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The khulasa, the summary is that the importance of fiqh have been mentioned in Quran, and there are multiple authentic narrations, for example, or in ahadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. For example, مَنْ يُرِدِ اللَّهُ بِهِ خَيْرًا يُفَقِّهُ فِي الدِّينِ, Bukhari and Muslim. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala intends goodness for someone, He gives him understanding of the religion. And another hadith, نَظَّرَ اللَّهُ امْرَأً سَمِعَ مِنَّا حَدِيثًا فَحَفِظَهُ حَتَّى يُبَلِّغَهُ فَرُبَّ حَامِلِ فِقْهٍ إِلَى مَنْ هُوَ أَفْقَهُ فَرُبَّ حَامِلِ فِقْهٍ إِلَى مَنْ هُوَ أَفْقَهُ مِنْهُ وَرُبَّ حَامِلِ فِقْهٍ لَيْسَ بِفَقِهِ. This is very famous narration. In fact, this narration, Imam Hakim rahimahullah ta'ala, in Mustadrak, he says that this is Mashhur hadith. If you have learnt or gone through the mustalah of hadith, the first status is mutawatir. Imam Suyuti rahimahullah ta'ala al-Shafi'i, he says that this hadith is a mutawatir hadith. This has been narrated by 16 sahaba ridwanullahi ta'ala ajma'in. So this is either mutawatir or mashhur. Is not much difference between them, but this narration, if someone denies a mutawatir or mashhur narration, then you can that person will be out of the fold of Islam. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala brighten the face of a person who hears a tradition, a hadith, from us, and he memorizes it until he can convey it to others. Perhaps he will convey it to the one who understands better than him, and perhaps one who conveys knowledge does not understand it himself. Now, because of this hadith, scholars, they have written, from this hadith, we can understand that a muhaddith, rubba hamil fiqh, he has fiqh, he has the knowledge of hadith, he has knowledge of different narrations, and which narrator is who, they know everything about the narrators, but they do not know what this fiqh or this hadith, how to implement ahkamat, the orders of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that there are scholars who have this the ilm, the knowledge of hadith, but those who they convey to, they are better in understanding, because they are faqih, they are fuqaha. So from this we understand that the faqih is better than a muhaddith, from this hadith. This is a conclusion some of the scholars come with. A famous muhaddith, his name is Sulaiman bin Mehran al-A'mash. Often he is mentioned as Al-A'mash in the hadith narrations. He says, يا معشر الفقهاء أنتم الأطباء ونحن الصيادلة. أنتم الأطباء. O فقهاء, O faqih people, you are like doctors. You are like doctors, and we, يعني محدثون, are the pharmacists. Pharmacists. We have the medicine, but you know how to utilize this medicine. How much medicine is to be given, it's only a knowledge which doctors have. So, subhanAllah, this also shows the importance of the fuqaha.